Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Chris once again, and today I'm gonna feature such a noteworthy, interesting, and very informative facts I had learned to discover during my short visit in Salisbury Cathedral in England. So, what to see in Salisbury? Let's find out as we go along. Salisbury Cathedral, formerly known as the Cathedral Church of Blessed Virgin Mary, is an Anglican cathedral in Salisbury, England. The cathedral is regarded as one of the leading examples of early English Gothic architecture. Its main body was completed in 38 years, from the year 1220 to 1258. It became a diocese since year 1220 and was consecrated in the year 1258. The Salisbury Cathedral attracts 500,000 visitors a year. Since 1549, the cathedral has had the tallest towering church, central spire, and largest cloister in the United Kingdom, which stood around 123 meters tall. Why are cathedrals so tall? Waging a constant battle against gravity, Master Masons who designed and built this cathedral wanted to create as much and uninterrupted vertical space as possible in their stone structures. The soaring heights provided a dramatic interior which serve to reinforce the power of the church. The cathedral is home to the largest and oldest complete set of choir stalls in England, made in the year 1236 from oak provided by King Henry. The cathedral's magnificent architectural design has had set the record as one of the leading examples of early English Gothic architecture. Gothic architecture refers to the architectural style that flourished in Europe during the High and Late Middle Ages. It evolves from Romanesque architecture, characterized by circular arches, and was succeeded by Renaissance architecture in the period between the early 14th and early 16th century. It was originated in 12th century in northern France as a development of Norman architecture. The cathedral is made of Purbeck marble, a crystalline limestone. The colors of the Wiltshire Regiment were hung on the walls above. There are two colors in each stand, the sovereign's color and the regimental color. The first of these has the Union flag of Great Britain, and the second displays campaigns and battles that the regiment has fought in. These colors and inscriptions placed here form a regimental memory for those who served in the Wiltshire Regiment, known to be the Duke of Edinburgh's. This standing receptacle is called the nave, new baptismal font that was installed in 2008, a state-of-the-art decorative font designed by William Pye, shaped like a Greek cross and large enough for total immersion baptism. It is made of patinated bronze with Purbeck freestone plinth and brown patinated bronze grating. It runs constantly like a fountain, yet its surface remains completely smooth, reflecting the captivating beauty of the cathedral. It's where we can find the oldest working clock in the world. Salisbury Cathedral Clock is a large iron frame tower clock without a dial, aged from 1386, a preserved example of earliest type of mechanical clock called as birds and folliot clocks, and it's said to be the oldest working clock in the world, although similar claims are made for other clocks. Here's the St. Lawrence Chapel. St. Lawrence was a deacon or minister of Rome of the 3rd century. He lived during a time of persecution and tradition. Has it that he was burned alive on a gridiron, which explains the design of the altar frontal in front of the chapel. You are invited to pray here for all who are suffered. Salisbury Cathedral displays one of the best preserved surviving Magna Carta among the other three that survive, out of perhaps 40 originals written in the year 1215. The other one is owned by the Lincoln Cathedral, and the remaining two others are by the British Library in London. Now, what's the relevance of this Magna Carta? Magna Carta was issued by King John at Runnymede on 15th June 1215. Like most medieval documents, the original Magna Carta is written in Latin with a quill pen on treated animal skin called parchment, a sheepskin, It consists of 3,500 words in abbreviated Latin, 63 clauses, and it took 50 hours to complete the writing. Magna Carta, a Latin word meaning Great Charter. King John ruled as a tyrant in the eyes of his rebellious barons and the church. After 16 years of ruling, they finally forced John to the negotiating table at Runnymede near Windsor on 15th June 1215. The king reluctantly agreed to the barons' demand and the resulting document became known as Magna Carta. Magna Carta has left fundamentally important legal legacies. It has also become a larger symbol of the general quest for freedoms, rights, and justice. It was intended mainly to protect the rights and wealth of a privileged elite, but it also asserted the freedom of the church, improved the justice system, and established the fundamental principle that even a monarch had to rule within and not above the law. This includes some elements like judgment by one's peers. It is where the important UK court cases are decided by a jury of ordinary people. Some people initially dread the idea, but when asked, most realize that a jury is in good way to ensure a fair trial. Citizens versus the state. In many countries, our rights include being able to take a government to court if we feel that the law is unfair or unfairly applied, as well as being tried by an impartial court in a quick, open process. Safeguarding justice. Yet in many countries, there are lapses in the application of justice. People are subject to emergency arrest and detained for months or years while awaiting trial. They and their families are denied access to their bank accounts and prevented from traveling. Innocent until proven guilty is another principle not always upheld. Nonetheless, we owe much to Magna Carta for establishing the principle of equality in the eyes of law. These things were an oak gall, a lamp formed when a wasp lays its egg in a leaf bud of an oak tree, was boiled with iron salts to produce ink. Skilled handwriters called scribes wrote using a quill made from the wing feather of goose or swan. Right-handers use quills from the bird's left wings. This is a replica of the Great Seal of King John. The seal would have originally have been attached at the base of the Magna Carta. One side of the seal depicts the king in idealized form, John on horseback as a knight in battle, wearing a flat-top helmet and carrying a shield. The text reads, John, Duke of Normandy and Aquitaine, Count of Anjou, while the other side shows John seated on his throne. He holds a sword, symbolizing his power and the sovereign's orb. The text reads, John, by the grace of God, King of England, Lord of Ireland. And so therefore, we should also give recognition and pay tribute to those small group of thoughtful, committed citizens, which we owe them a lot. Their greatest contribution and commendable actions moved to change the world, which led for the establishment of Magna Carta. There's no doubt that its clauses on social justice are as pertinent today as they were in 1215. It has inspired the United Nations Declaration of Human Rights, American Bill of Rights, and the constitutions of many democratic countries. This is why the four Magna Carta were entered onto this UNESCO Memory of World Register. So this is all for now, guys. I hope you find it worthy to share too. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.